What's going on, everybody? Sonar here. And though it doesn't feel like it right now, fall is right around the corner. Cooler temps are on their way. And with that comes that migration of the shad from the main lake to the backs of the creeks and the pockets. And the bass are right behind them, and they put the feed bag on, let me tell you. And one of the best tactics for catching these shad-gorging fish is with a spinnerbait. It's been that way for decades, and it's only getting better because Z-Man just introduced the brand new SlingBladeZ, which has a lot of innovative design features on it. It's got a brand new wire material, which is very strong, but also has a lot of vibration, which is a combination you don't see in other materials. It's got a 3D modeled head design, very realistic. It's got great scale pattern, great realistic eyes on it, but it also has this concave bottom on it, which allows it to track perfectly straight. It's perfectly balanced, which is something that's extremely important when it comes to spinnerbait fishing. There's nothing worse than getting a spinnerbait that you just can't tune correctly, and I haven't had that problem at all with any of these baits. And of course, it's got a high quality hook, very strong, very sharp. It's got a bait keeper on it that does extremely well with all different types of soft plastics, including Elastec. It's got a hand-tied skirt that has a copper wire that it's hand-tied with. And the skirts, let me tell you, man, they just come in the best color combinations as well as the best blade combinations. So overall, the SlingBladeZ is a winner, and it's revolutionized my spinnerbait fishing, and I know it will for you too. And I wanted to show you my favorite spinnerbait setup, rod, reel, line. Essentially, let's start with the rod. The rod that I use, I like a 7-foot rod, and the reason for that is a 7-foot is kind of that happy medium between having a longer rod for longer casts, but it's also short enough to be able to make those pinpoint precision casts around heavy cover, which is really important. So I like a 7-footer. This right here is a 7-foot heavy action Fitzgerald rod. This is a Versus series, and I like the heavy action in the Versus series because it still has a soft enough tip for precise casting, but it also has a heavier backbone so you can get good solid hook sets and guide those fish away from that heavy cover, which is extremely important. Next, let's talk about the reel. The reel that I use is a Quantum Tour S3, and I like the higher speed gear ratios. 7.3 to 1 is kind of my favorite gear ratio for spinnerbaits because it allows me to cover more water, be more efficient, and also control the speed of my retrieve a lot better. But it allows me to catch up with those fish when they slap at the bait and kind of hit it from behind. So that's very important to have a higher speed gear ratio, in my humble opinion. So I like the Quantum Tour S3, 7.3 to 1. That's really important. And then finally, the line that I use fluorocarbon line 100% of the time when I'm spinnerbait fishing, and I use 17 and 20 pound test primarily. This is a reaction style technique, a power fishing tactic. So you're not gonna see these fish getting line shy because they're not gonna see it long enough. So you can use heavier line. But if you're in a situation where you want this bait to get a little bit deeper, that's the only situation that I go down to maybe 14 or 15 pound test fluorocarbon. But overall, 17, 20 pound test is gonna get the job done. So that is my combo for spinnerbait fishing. You know, overall, this fall is gonna be pretty exciting because I got the brand new SlingBladeZ. You gotta check that out at zmanfishing.com, and check out these other components too if you're looking for the perfect spinnerbait combo. I'll see you guys out on the water.